Hello and welcome. My name is Daria Volkova, and this channel helps you utilize Grafana to its full potential. Today's video is about the Canvas panel. Starting from the Grafana 10, the Canvas panel is generally available. This means it is now a part of the core Grafana and could be used for the production use cases. If you saw those breathtaking presentations on the Grafana website, you might wonder what it takes to build something magnificent like that. Rotating windmills and animated electricity circuits in the house. Very impressive, right? And here is where my video comes in handy. Michael and I closely looked at the Canvas panel and built this pizzeria observability dashboard. Here we use a PNG background, animated SVG for pizza ovens to depict baking statuses, and metric value elements. Are you ready to learn how we did all that? Let's go! I will start with the background, then touch upon simple elements, alpha elements, and towards the end I will explain how to create your own advanced elements where parts of the image change depending on the parameters values. Background. I start by creating a dashboard, then add, visualization, select canvas from the dropdown, and click Apply. Here's what the panel looks like by default. The context menu is the feature that makes this panel stand out. It appears after a right click. Let me open the Set Background menu. Here you can select a file from a folder or a specified URL. I want to select it from a folder. My Grafana is in a Docker container, so using the terminal tool, I copy the file of my choice into the emgbg folder using dockercp command. Then I go back to Grafana and here I can select the new file. Then in edit mode, I have options to contain, cover, fill, or tile. This all is pretty straightforward, right? In addition to a static image, I can load an animated GIF for the background. For that, I follow the same steps. Copy an animated GIF image into the emgbg folder, and in Grafana, select it in the configuration section. Here, I try to have a water pumping effect. If you look at Grafana's presentation on house electricity, you will see just that, a GIF file loaded as a background. The picture does not have any parameters. Moving to simple elements. Those are items that are displayed on top of your background. The background is always in the back, while one element can be on top of the other. To start working with simple elements, you can right-click on the Canvas panel and go to the Add Item menu. First on the list is metric value. Once any element is on the canvas, it has its own specific menu. You can edit, delete, duplicate, bring an element to the front, send element to the back, or open the inline editor. This field is the same option as in the Edit menu. Here you can select a data source field if you have connected any data source. By default, the Grafana data source is connected and you have these two fields. You also can go into edit mode, click on the element you want to edit, scroll down, and here is the same configuration menu that you have in the inline editor. Options in the edit mode and the inline editor allow you to do exact same thing. However, when you work on precise placements of your elements, I recommend the inline editor instead of edit mode. I will demonstrate the reason later in the video. Let's go back to the Canvas context menu. I will skip the text and rectangle elements. They are self-explanatory. Instead, I will select icon. An icon element represents an SVG image. By default, it looks like a question mark in a circle. I right-click on it and go into the inline editor. Here I can select another image to display. Grafana offers a lot of handy images to choose from. Let me scroll down to the end. All these pictures' names start with A, with the last available being the Accessive Listening System SVG. Now, if I open this Unicorns folder in my Docker container, I find many more images. If I copy this name, for instance, go back to Grafana and insert it on the URL tab here, the picture appears in the selection, and if I click to select it, it appears on my dashboard. I believe this workaround will not be needed soon, but until the fix is in place, feel free to explore available images in the folder. You sure can use your own SVG. For that, copy it into the same Unicons folder. I use docrcp command for that. After copying, the image appears for selection. Here you go, I have my own SVG on my dashboard. Now it's a good time to show the difference between the inline editor and the edit mode. From what I have registered, the positioning of elements and the background size are not nicely scalable. That means your layout will look adequate only on one screen size. So the layout is skewed when you look at the canvas panel in edit mode. You want to use the inline editor to work with positioning and alignment. If you have other thoughts, please share them in the comments below. The panel is new to me as well, I might have missed something. Let's get back to the Canvas context menu. The next choice is Server. The Server menu is a collection of built-in images. Your options are Stack, Database, and Terminal. The Canvas panel has a button item. It's an alpha element. Alpha elements manifest great ideas that developers would like to share with the world, but because the realization is raw, there is no version compatibility guarantee. To have a button for Canvas, you need to enable all alpha elements using the enable_alpha configuration. Then you can select a button from the dropdown. In the configuration, you can specify an API call and data that will be sent out. The button element has been long awaited for. It's a conceptual breakthrough, indicating that Core Grafana can soon talk back to your systems via submitting API calls. Until then, you can employ the data manipulation plugin that works with API calls in style. You can connect elements with arrows, but connections are still a work in progress, so many good features will follow in the future. For now, connections are static, though they look like a fantastic start. And now to the most exciting part, how to add an animated SVG. In the edit mode, I have this toggle to show advanced element types. When it is on, in addition to the metric value and other not advanced elements, I have a wind turbine and three views of a drone. The advanced elements have specific to them configuration. For instance, the wind turbine has RPM. It regulates how fast it rotates. Though possible, it is highly unlikely that the existing advanced elements will suffice the most use cases. I have a feeling you might want to have something specific to your business. At this time, the Canvas panel does not provide a user interface where you can add your advanced element by clicking buttons and selecting something from the menu. The only way to do that is by working with Grafana source code. The process of having your own animated SVG could be split into the following steps. Step 1. Prepare animated SVG. This is done outside Grafana. We use the online Figma tool for that. By prepare, I mean giving unique identifiers to the elements of your SVG that you want to change or move. For instance, I have pizza. We change the opacity from 0 to 100 to indicate the stages of baking. We also have smoke and timer. Down the line, we will change the parameters of the identified SVG parts and assemble the final SVG image on the Grafana dashboard. Step 2 is to fetch the parameters from the data source. Parameters are the values that tell how exactly every element in the SVG image should look. This code will be called every time my data changes to update the timer and state parameters. And I'm not going deeper into coding, but I can tell you precisely what you can do to have the exact visualization. On our blog, recently posted this article. It contains almost everything you need to replicate our project. Scroll to the React Display Component part. The code of the oven is here. It's pretty long due to our realistic pizzas with more than 200 layers. You can copy this code and create a new file in this folder. Then you need to register the oven as an advanced element. For that, use the following piece of code and place it into the existing registry.ts file. If needed, follow the steps of developing and building a Docker image. Right after all that, you should see the pizza oven in the drop-down list. I know the way of adding custom animated SVG is not as easy as you might have anticipated. But the most crucial part, there is a way, and we have documented it quite well. Let me know what you think about the Canvas panel. I would happily look at your use case and share it with the world. Now is the perfect time to subscribe to our channel. Many of our subscribers became members. We appreciate your support more than you know. Thank you. That is all for now. Thank you for watching and see you next time.